Hello guys, we're back and we're gonna meet Silas. I hope, I wish, I doubt it to be honest, but we're gonna try, and that's all that matters. Why is it so quiet? It feels weird.
Some love for longevity before fading to dust.
Stop, I'm excited again. What the heck? They always want me to update stuff. What's going on? I'm muting it for right now. I think that we should do something while we're reading. Let's do Wordle. Okay. Wordle. Why do I need music in the background? Okay, R&B playlist. Let's turn that on just a bit.
As a corporate girly, I'm constantly thinking about how to make my email messages
And
pop, how to turn
then
my thoughts and words into magic. I have all these thoughts and ideas, but sometimes struggle with structuring them to be effective.
skip. Okay, Wordle. Let's go. Fight. That did nothing. Cloud. Where? Okay, we got L. Okay.
Demons from my younger days. I wish I could see.
I think B. Okay, Blake? Blame, duh. What? Wait a minute. What? Blaze? It could be so many things. Okay, that was close. That was scary. Connections. Is this too loud? I can't even hear my voice. Okay, connections. What do we have? Sweet. Money. Yeah, that's the same Cigna. Feeling tender, touching. Wait a second. Listening, hearing, touching. Those are the same. Sense. What? Okay, it's not sense. Feeling? Feeling, hunch, sense are the same. Inquiry. What? I'm lost now. Hunch, feeling, sense, inquiry. Oh, hearing, listening, touching. Bruh, I'm lost. Why is this so hard? I don't know. Didn't I do that? I thought I did that. Well, let's do something else. November 1st. Never mind. I was really doing that. Okay, what other games can we play? The crossword. Oh! I don't know. The game's ready. Let's go. It's time to lock in. No more music. No more music. Actually, let me switch. Okay, let's go. Love at first sight leads to precious beginnings. Okay. I was like, am I stuck? Ooh.
It's you.
Bro, this guy, I think he's toxic. I drop by here sometimes because the coffee is but that's good. Just my you opinion. I think he's taste. Toxic. We share a similar taste, my booty cheeks. It's okay if you can't stop by next time. Just remember, you have your phone next time. Bruh, to be honest, I don't like you. He's cute. Don't get me wrong, he's cute, but he's just so unfeeling. He's very much harsh, and I don't like it. It's giving toxic. Anyway, we're gonna continue the story so we can meet Silas. because everybody talks about Silas. After the butler and Zane leave, I begin to explore the mansion. While the skeleton is suspicious, neither the hunter's watch nor my eval can detect any metal flux from it. Maybe it is just a quirky decoration. I climb up the stairs. Above me is the collection room on the third floor. Through the door, I can hear two people talking.
I've invited you to my home several times before. You only visit when I'm not feeling well. Dr. Zane, I wonder if you see me as a patient or just a subject for observation.
According to the OXO remote monitor, your vital sign data has improved. The equipment also determined your age to be far younger than what it actually is.
Oh.
Aren't you curious about why I haven't died yet?
I'll admit I was for a time. However, it was nothing more than that.
Even his voice is kind of suspicious. Like, he seems like he'll slam you against the wall. Sorry. That's not even related to the plot. Okay. The silence in the mansion almost amplifies every sound, making the conversation upstairs anything but pleasant. I'm hesitant about climbing up the steps. I'll wait for them to finish talking. Good decision. I haven't even taken two steps when a bone-chilling laugh resounds, followed by a feeble coughing fit. Dang.
Your colleague praised you, saying there are things only the two of you can do. I'm very curious now. Xander Sciences will provide you with the best staff, the best lab, and even the best treatment. Dr. Zane, what you perceive as the limit of your talent is just another beginning in your career.
When you reach the finish line, I'll be right there cheering for you.
Okay. Lost in thought, I lean on the windowsill by the staircase, gazing at the chirping birds outside. The sound of footsteps bring me back to reality. I turn around to see Zane going down the stairs. He doesn't look away. On the handrail, his hand has countless faint scars.
Listening in?
Jesus. Not really. It seems like someone is trying to headhunt you. You're good at not giving in to temptation.
Please don't put me on a pedestal. I'm just a normal doctor. I have no intention of straying from the path I've chosen.
Okay. Eavesdropping isn't exactly polite, especially when Zane's personal matters are involved. I steer the conversation in a different direction. A normal doctor who won the Star Catcher Award and is the youngest person to receive the Lend Award. I promise I'll never be late to your appointments in the future. I make a gesture to show I'm swearing on my honor as a joke. Zane reaches out to put my hand back at my side, but then an almost imperceptible ripple appears in the air, like someone plucked a cord. Hey, Joyce! It's Metaflux! The resonance trail leads straight to the collection room. I run up the last few steps, and the hunter's watch confirms my suspicions. Metaflux is gathering at an alarming speed behind the heavy door. The current situation forces me to kick down the door. Raymond is sprawled out on the carpet, unconscious. Ooh. The lights flicker as I sense an invisible pressure weighing down on me. The wanderer is on the move. Zane, get him out of here. I'll handle this.
How long will you be able to last?
He can say that in a bit. Whoosh! An icicle flies towards the wanderer that appeared. In the blink of an eye, Zane is standing next to me.
Let's make this quick, shall we?
What he about to do? Isn't he a doctor? What is he about to do? complete the mission with your companion. Why? Like, isn't he a doctor?
It could appear at any moment. Be careful.
Don't let your guard.
Dang, this
either.
Is a huge mansion.
Watch out.
Oh crap. Oh heck no. Jump scare. Triggering the dodge. Okay.
Have you recovered? I'll freeze it for you.
What is he, a magician?
Here comes another attack.
It's a tough one.
I really wish I could change the angle. I don't like this angle.
You have me if you need me.
What is he doing? There's no way this doctor is just freaking being a magician. Ooh. Why am I so close to him? Girl, I'll be flexing for nothing because I don't be doing anything. I'm just running around. He's doing everything. Ooh. Well, yeah, it's my job. You're literally a doctor. Like, what are you doing? You shouldn't even be here. Ooh, I went the wrong way with that one.
Our culprit finally revealed itself.
There it is.
No, seriously. This is me in the lab. If you're attacked, your companion may come. Ooh. I'm sorry, what? I didn't even fully read that, I'm not gonna lie. Eliminate it.
I'll wrap it up from here. Thanks, Dr. Zane.
Guys, that's how he sounds in the bed. I'm telling you that. But he's like toxic. I just know he's toxic. Stage cleared. HP no less than 50%. 1 in 20. I'm like good. Good or whatever. Why do I always need a man beside me when I hunt? Why can't I just hunt by myself? Ooh! Bro, he looks so good. He's definitely toxic. If someone said this to me, you see this? This is like a baby. If someone said this to me, that would be my child. My child would exist. For a long time, my gaze has always been yours. That's insane. That's literally insane. He ate with that one.
Male,
I'm afraid.
39 years old. He collapsed from shock because a wanderer appeared 5 minutes ago. No external injuries. His heart rate is normal and his pupils react normally to light.
Okay.
The address is...
After contacting a rescue helicopter, Zane helps the butler move Raymond to another room. The hunter's watch scans every corner of the collection room, sending data back to HQ. Intelligentsia type, estimated threat level to be at least B, had yet to form a protocol. There are no casualties or any metaflux, over and out. A notification appears telling me the mission is now considered complete, but I can't shake off this lingering feeling of unease. While the wanderer has been dealt with, something's still off about this room. Huh? That's... A stunning oil painting hangs on the wall opposite of the sofa. It depicts a brilliantly blue sea with cascading white waves. Each brushstroke feels like it. Brushstroke feels alive as if countless fairies are jumping out of the water. At the edge of the sea, the water is gradually stained crimson like something is being torn apart, swallowed, and coalescing into a blood clot. What a peculiar painting. I try to scan it, but there's nothing. I place my hand on the frame and try to resonate with it. The gloomy weather, the sound of the ocean, a salt humidity slow creeps into my ear. slowly creeps into my ear. This is I come back to my senses and realize I'm standing in the ocean. I turn around and spot a girl by the shore. The lower half of her body is submerged in water. Strange. It's almost like she's crying and laughing at the same time. The swirling fog carries a faint, ethereal melody on the sea breeze. It sounds like a song, yet is also a lament. I can't help but move toward her, but the fog becomes increasingly dense, and everything begins to blur. A chilling cold gradually surrounds me.
Snap out of it.
Ooh. Stop the music eats. I'm afraid the score freaking eats for this game. I blink a few times. I'm back in Raymond's collection room.
Did something catch your eye? You were in a daze.
His eyes. You see, like, how he looks at you? Wow. Anyway, Zane frowns, holding a cup that's been completely frozen, speechless. I touch my neck. Seriously? You've been smacking it against my neck?
The teacup didn't work, so I had no choice but to increase the dosage. What happened?
I shake my head and look at the painting again. A Metaflix-infused painting causing hallucinations. Could this be why Raymond was acting strange? Was it also the Wanderer's hiding place? The rescue helicopter arrives and takes in the unconscious Raymond. Zane insists on accompanying him to the hospital.
Take care. Try not to forget the time of your next checkup.
I know. Don't forget about your car. Make sure it gets repaired.
Thank you.
Watching the helicopter disappear into the clouds, I let out a sigh of relief. I turn on my comms again and look at the mansion. Mission HMU-0048-3015. Coordinates are my current location. There's an oil painting that needs special treatment. Okay. They're like, you want to meet Zane. Experience the romantic episodes between just you two. Okay. On my window sill sits a small seal made of unmelting snow. It's always been my companion ever since I met Zane again. Yet in distant memories, it still was. Ooh. Okay, childhood friend to lovers. It happened 6 months ago when Zane just be up. After another day of studying for the Hunter's exam, I realized I had an adism. By the time I dragged my weary self to the restaurant,
I promise you, this restaurant is really good.
But I read slower out loud than in my head, and it's so hard. Okay.
That will be all. Thank you.
Hey, stop. This is nice. A cat! So cute! It's a cat. Oh, that's what he gave me. He wants me so bad, bruh.
I'm starving.
That's like so random. You either get steak or you get like cheese bread. He is toxic. You can tell by his voice too.
Sorry.
Not even just
we're
the cat, but
right
his
now.
Voice.
Would you mind waiting? You're out of tables?
Do you want to go watch a movie
so...
after lunch?
Yeah, that is. That's on plate up. Zane.
There's this new sci-fi movie that's
huh?
out, I think.
Zane?
Let me check. You know each other? Maybe you can share
bruh,
a
bruh, his power is like ice because he's ice. He's like icy.
That might not be.
Please.
Oh,
he's please. Bruh, he wants me so bad.
I'll give you some time to decide then.
Yes, please. I'll have the lunch special, please.
That's a small menu, too. Like, there were like five options. And they're all very different.
Zane hasn't said a word since I sat down. Earlier, I thought I saw you making a little snow cat. It was so cute.
No, you are mistaken.
Like, why can't you be cute?
What a liar.
Exactly.
Was,
he's gaslighting me.
I was surprised when I found out you were the new attending physician.
Were you, though?
The weather's really
and
nice
he
today.
Has... He's so conceited. He's so cocky.
Only getting more awkward.
Like, he doesn't know how to socialize, but like, he wants me, so it makes signals. I'm shutting up.
I should probably just stop talking.
You. How is preparing for the hunter's exam?
It's going well. I'm sleeping early, waking up early, and eating three meals a day.
It's 3 in the afternoon. Your meals seem to be quite late.
Aren't you here?
You're eating a late lunch, too.
Here, please enjoy your meal.
Okay, so he got the steak. Ooh, okay.
How
are those potatoes or wings? You're staring into my soul, bruh.
Taro ice cream for dessert.
Ooh,
enjoy.
I love taro ice cream.
He didn't say anything.
I've never had taro ice cream.
Then, Zane hardly ever spoke to me.
What is it?
It's nothing. I was just thinking.
Oh, so we're reminiscing. Yeah, we're gonna reminisce.
This place, it used to be a pet store, not a restaurant, right?
That's a twist.
I remember seeing you around here a few times.
I must have taken a wrong turn when going to the bookstore nearby.
Wrong turn?
How's your family been? Is your grandma doing okay?
Yes, grandma's doing fine. As soon as she found out that you were my doctor, she said she could rest easy, knowing I was in good hands.
No, seriously.
Ice cream's
she's like,
melting.
How's your grandma?
Remember when we went to the aquarium together?
Maybe I shouldn't have reminisced.
To see the seals?
Because it sounds like
so
Taylor
mad
wants
when
him.
That seal threw ice at me, and then you sent over a bunch of snowballs the very next day, just to mock me.
To mock you?
You left them in a box in front of my door. Looked exactly like this ice cream, all meticulously arranged, too.
Those snowballs, do you still have them?
You used your Evol to make them, right? The snowballs didn't melt. You totally did that on purpose. I had planned on throwing them at
why
you,
is this making me hungry?
Who knew we wouldn't see each other again?
Have a nice day.
I always passed by this street on my way home. It's amazing how much it changed.
Still reminiscing?
Well, if I didn't run into you again, I would have never realized how time flies. Everything changes.
I was thinking that too.
Except for those three snowballs.
Just forget they even exist. You can pretend I never gave them to you.
So, you're not gonna tease me anymore?
That's what I'm saying. Like, what?
Or maybe I was never teasing you in the first place.
Huh. Did he make Kirby?
Please, try not to mistake it for some snowballs this time.
What is it? I'm lost.
A seal.
Oh, a seal. Then, oh, wait, stop. That's a cute. That's a cute face.
I have work this afternoon, so I'll be leaving now.
Bro, he's so distant. This guy needs therapy. I don't know what happened in his past, but he needs therapy.
Before this place changes, that is.
There's something about it. He doesn't know how to express his emotions.
If you promise not to disappear again. See you later? At the hospital or wherever?
Yes, he does need to evaluate his set points.
Zane, it's good to see you again.
Girl, is it really? Let's be for real for a moment. It's because you haven't met Silas yet. I haven't met Silas yet. Okay. We ate with that. Why am I still going on dates with this guy? I should continue the storyline. But we'll see how this turns out. Oh!
Passed by this street.
Never mind. Beck! I didn't know it was the same storyline. Okay. Let's go back to the story. The oil painting is taken back to HQ. I sit down in a chair at the data analysis as Tara skillfully pulls up information from various databases.
There wasn't a lot of metaflux to extract. It'll be a while before the analysis gives us any useful info.
Can we figure out where the painting came from?
Already ahead of you. Sold from an art gallery called Flux Arts. It's owned by Thomas. He's a professional art broker.
If it's literally called Flux Arts, it's no surprise that a metaflux was in it. Let's think. Let's use our brains, guys. Critical analysis. Raphael! Look, I said it before. She said
He's
it.
He's pretty famous. Always on the news. Probably why you've heard of him before.
Beep. The transmission is complete. Tara's synchronized data appears on my hunter's watch. Raphael, 24 years old, an artist who returned to the country at the start of this year. He's a once-in-a-century genius. Records show Raphael came back from a trip not too long ago. He's an odd one. No one knows his background or his hometown. Ooh, mysterious. He rarely interacts with other artists.
Industry insiders say Raphael locks himself in his studio for half the year, then spends the rest of his time traveling the world for inspiration. As for his paintings, just last month, his art broke the record for highest selling price at Lizio auctions. An artist of this caliber, meeting him in person might be challenging.
I skimmed through the long list of awards before stopping to look at a photo of him. A sense of deja vu watches over me. He's that rambling weirdo with the fish. What? The photo is a good shot. Through the glass and in the mirror of a crowd, it captures the moment he turns to look at the camera. He seems to be smiling, yet there's a subtle aloofness. He's quite different from the person I met at that time. Might be challenging, still means there's a chance. Where is the gallery located? The next morning, the Hunters Association arranges a meeting with Thomas. He's not only the owner of Flux Arts, but also Raphael's agent. Aside from running the gallery, he handles all external affairs for this artist. Since Raphael refuses visitors, Thomas is the only ticket to meeting the man himself. A white building stands tall in the city's central business district. Flux Art is on the highest floor.
I'm sorry. Thomas is dealing with an emergency right now. If you're not in a hurry, he said you could walk around the exhibition as you wait.
Thank you very much. After giving me a guidebook, the staff member quickly leaves. In the exhibition, the snow-white walls are bare. The overhead lights cast a soft light on them. The more I walk around, the more empty and lonely this place is. There doesn't seem to be any fluctuations. A spotlight illuminates a large oil painting taking up half a wall. As I get closer to it, I can see each delicately painted brushstroke, the different colored layers representing the sea. This painting is...
The Day of Ebbing.
Ooh, yeah, he has a nice voice. A voice from who knows where echoes throughout the large exhibition. It sounds familiar. I look around, but the hall is empty.
Every year, there's a day when the tides go against the ocean currents. And using the night's countercurrent, creatures from the deep sea are washed ashore. Once the tides recede at dawn, they return home. As a result, everything they met that night turns into distant memories of the surface world.
He's smart too, guys.
Some deep sea creatures are obsessed with the world outside the ocean. Desiring its warmth, they stubbornly wait for the sunrise before
returning.
But
he's also lonely.
All just for a sun they've never, ever seen before.
I wish I can highlight this. This guy, he says, desiring its warmth. It's because he relates this. He relates to it, and he's lonely. Just like the exhibition hall. Bare and lonely and cold. But I can warm him up. Who are you? That's insane. The person stops talking. Seconds turn into minutes before he responds in a languid tone.
Hey, I'm Raphael. This is my art exhibition.
Per. They didn't even show his face. I just realized that. That's like a cliffhanger. They said you're going to the next episode. The exhibition hall is silent. The hologram projector casts a soft glow as if to reflect faint particles in the air. Are you... What is a voice assistant? You're Raphael hiding.
I'm the embodiment of his inspiration and thoughts, more or less.
What? That's crazy. He's really antisocial. His voice, I'm laughing like I'm not antisocial. Okay, we're back. His voice is cold yet laced with a hint of nonchalance, period. It's an AI. Will you answer any questions I ask about the paintings?
Yeah, sure. If I know the answer, that is.
Okay. Well, I'd appreciate it if you could show me around. If this doesn't exist in 2034, am I even in 2034, you know? After turning a few corners, I find myself in a separate exhibition room, but there isn't anything on the wall. According to the guidebook, the painting that's supposed to be here is the one Raymond purchased.
The painting can't be properly displayed at the moment, so we're just gonna use some fancy hologram tech.
Okay. A beam of light shines from above onto the wall, colors chaotically mixed together on this makeshift canvas. Waves of white sea foam appear, the azure ocean rippling out and revealing a gradient of colors from the water's surface to its depths. It feels similar to the painting I saw in Raymond's mansion, but not quite. So, what's the story behind this painting?
A dream.
His voice is suddenly softer, carrying an indescribable sadness.
When I was a kid, I had dreamed I turned into a fish.
I think we should stop. That's insane. Thanks for sharing. I'm gonna add a chat box. There is none. Anyway. That's exactly what it's giving. That's exactly what it's giving. It's giving, I apologize too much because this. Bruh.
I swam and swam and swam from the deep sea, seeking a place beyond the water's surface, only to end up in blood-red seawater.
Okay, Moses. The light shifts with his voice, casting a shimmering gleam. It's like looking at the glittering waves. The room seems to ebb and flow like the sea. A pinkish hue gradually shifts into a dark crimson. Why did the sea turn red? He doesn't answer my question. Maybe he didn't detect any important keywords, so he just kept talking.
It was the first time I ever saw such a color. Who knows how many years I've spent trying to recreate it, but I never really could get that same shade of red.
Okay.
It was always a slightly different hue, you know?
I do know. For some reason, I could almost hear the faint melody from Raymond's mansion again.
Sorry, miss.
The lights in the exhibition hall return to normal and the hologram vanishes. As if waking from a dream, I turn around to see a man standing behind me. He must have approached me when I wasn't looking.
I'm Raphael's art gallery manager, Thomas.
His voice and face are not matching up. Thomas sounds like a 40-year-old man. What I see in front of me is like a guy in his 20s. You know, Thomas leans back in his uniquely designed chair, crossing his legs. His leather dress shoes shine. He motions for me to sit down across from him. I fill him in on what transpired at Raymond's mansion. I even mentioned the Wanderer being possibly connected to the painting. Thomas's face turns pale, but he quickly regains his composure.
So you're suggesting Raphael might have messed with his own painting?
I think you might have messed with his painting. It doesn't matter if he's responsible or not, since the Wanderer could have been in the art, his studio, Raphael himself, and even your gallery might be in danger. Please tell me everything you know. Thomas rubs his expensive cufflinks, hesitating. It's expensive because he's doing dirty work. Anyway, it takes a while before he finally speaks.
Mr. Raymond, a renowned art collector famous for his discerning taste, graced Flux Arts with his presence last month.
Okay.
Despite the gallery being filled with better paintings, he was utterly smitten with that one. He needed to buy it.
He sounds like he doesn't like Mr. Raymond.
Had to nag Raphael before he finally agreed to sell it. During the process of arranging, displaying, and selling the painting, more than a dozen people have been in contact with it. No one mentioned anything about a wanderer.
But what if someone starts to hallucinate because of this art? Thomas pauses for a moment, then bursts into a fit of laughter.
What a nice compliment. Making people literally go crazy over artwork isn't something many artists can pull off these days.
Boy, are you saying he's trying to cause drama to increase the value of his work? Thomas clears his throat and rubs his nose.
I wish. If Raphael cared about that stuff, my job would be a piece of cake. Wait until you meet him. You'll see what I mean. He did mention something a while back, said he often heard strange noises in the studio late at night. I thought he was trying to trick me.
It was me. It was me here. Signal.
Mondays, Wednesdays, Fridays, he's sick. Tuesdays, Thursdays, Saturdays, a wanderer showed up.
Hmm?
Could you do me a favor and check if there's actually a wanderer at his studio? I would love to see the tomfoolery he plans to do next.
Dang! He sounds like a horrible agent. Dude's probably actually struggling. A thread of light quivers in the air. The sudden metaflex fluctuation draws my attention to a display case by the wall. What are those over there? He looks over his shoulder.
Oh, coral stones. Raphael uses them for his paint. Are you interested in them?
Walking up to the display case, I see the stones are a vibrant red, almost like blood. I pick one up. This is the source. Can I take it with me when I see Raphael?
Sure.
Thomas walks over to the French window. Outside is beautiful scenery as far as the eye can see. I look at where he's pointing. In the distance is a gorgeous ivory structure extending toward the sea.
Visit the giant white building over there on White Sand Bay. That's where he lives. His memory is non-existent, so the door's open. You can just walk right in. Could you tell him to hurry up on that painting he's working on? I already sold it to someone.
Dang. This dude only cares about money.
He's here, right? I sense energy traces behind this door.
Stop. We love an artist. This is in the, ooh.
Who is it? The studio's closed. Wait.
Not Bob Ross.
Before you.
Oh my gosh. Look at his brown eyes, guys. Look at his brown eyes.
You.
Ow, whoa, 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 whoa. Let go. Let go of me.
That's crazy. That's crazy. That's crazy. Why can't meet cutes happen like this nowadays?
I really can't tell if it's destiny or bad karma for us to meet again after 2 days. Anyway, you're not here to check on the fish, are you?
You know that I'm a hunter, right? I'm here to deal with the wanderer problem.
Oh? I had no idea there was something dangerous at the studio. Ah, wait. Now I remember. I did hear some weird noises while I was painting earlier. It was very annoying. Thomas said
he does seem condescending.
A wanderer queuing on his canvas?
He's so good looking.
So where are they?
Touch.
I can use my ears to locate some prey. It's probably downstairs, upstairs, or somewhere else. In any case, wanderers are everywhere. Literally. I even heard there's one that's sort of like a lemon. Am I wrong? One time I dreamt about slimy rainbow-colored wanderers.
They
can't be mutated.
He does.
Like the Raphael in those magazine interviews. Is this what you use to make your paints?
Thomas let you have it?
Other than rocks, do you use anything else that's weird?
Well, nothing is weird if you can get color from it. Fine. Do mummy bandages count? Different refinement processes don't necessarily produce the same tint of brown,
though.
That's
not what I meant. What else is there?
This guy is interesting.
You've asked me so many questions.
What?
Yet you're not here to solve my issues, are you?
What are you?
What?
I've only used this batch of coral stone pigment for one painting.
Okay.
So you knew about Raymond. His erratic behavior is related to you.
What sort of twisted logic is this? And why are you only thinking about everyone else? I'm a victim too.
Not him.
Also, that coral stone is mine. Give it to me. Now.
You're not going
Didn't
to tell
we just
truth,
meet?
Are you?
Like, why is he
if
being a brat?
If your art any more problems, it won't be just me next time.
Really? A hunter can only be patient for 3 minutes?
Well, also enemies to lovers. It's like, nah.
Let me check first. I also would like to know if the problem here is the coral stone.
It's hot. Illusions.
Well, that explains why I started hearing things right after getting a paper cut.
Fluctuations. Do you have a lot of valuables here?
Depends on who you ask.
Answer me.
Not really.
Then you should hide. Now, leave the wanderer to me.
And then he's about to join in.
This is my house.
And he's just a regular civilian. He's literally just Bob Ross.
You should be the one hiding. Don't damage my treasures.
You should be the one hiding. Dude, who are you? What? That knife is cool. I would buy that in real life. This girl, I don't even know how she got into the best fighting sect a hunter can get into, because she be using, like, she always has like some random companion every single mission. She never does it herself.
Wanderers. Is it up ahead, maybe?
Which is not bad, but like, still.
Should we go together?
Like, dang. Ooh, a crab. This shows the current number of layers. Oh.
Snow crabs? In this economy?
That's what I'm saying, bruh. That's me! In this economy? Exactly.
It's trying really Ooh. Hard to act tough, huh?
Look out! It's about to throw a fit.
This is taking forever, and I'm barely doing any damage to it.
Because I'm better than you. It's like, nah. Ooh, heck no. Okay. Okay.
We destroyed one layer. Good job. Shouldn't we use another resonance skill?
Our
teamwork is definitely getting better. Don't you think?
I guess.
Ooh.
They want me to use that so bad. Wait, stop. I love this animation.
We completely destroyed its protocol shield. Attack.
Yes, let's go. Extra damage. Unleash the Ardent Oath. Ooh. Ooh. Raphael is cute.
I guess fighting in a team can be pretty fun.
Leave it to the professionals.
Girl. Oh, sorry. Why did she say professionals? You're one person. Okay.
Looks like they're all A-okay. The Wanderer was nice enough not to harm them.
I see this coral stone is imbued with some metaflux. Where did you get it?
You can't just buy coral stones from the market. I might have bartered with the Sardinian locals, or maybe...
Your memory cannot be that bad.
Wanna check my collection log?
Do you have a log?
He sounds like a Pokemon trainer.
There are millions of colors. Some people even create
like Animal Crossing.
If there's actually a problem with the source, how are you guys gonna deal with it?
Investigate. Might have to close off the area.
I won't just give it to you for free. Unless we get an alternative. Coral stones can be found near Lincoln City. I was planning to have a look-see. It's a shame I got injured today. I can't even lift a paintbrush. I'll be in trouble if I encounter any danger.
All right. What do you want?
I saw how you fought. Quick and precise. That final strike
was
unlike
anything
I've
seen
before. If you could be my bodyguard.
What?
Mm-hmm. Protect me on our journey together. If we find an alternative, I'll happily give you what's in my hand right now.
I can definitely guard his body. Yeah, he is a bit zesty. I'm not gonna lie.
Consider this a private commission from yours truly.
But enemies to lovers.
The door is over there.
This mission is too important.
So far, the first guy, I don't even remember his name. But the first guy is the best personality wise.
Great. I'll let you know the time.
Raphael and Zane, I like their look. Ooh. I think I like Raphael better.
Is in your hands.
Ooh. Yeah. They did their thing on his look. Yup. Look at that. Look at those eyes. I look out the train's window. The scenery rapidly fades into the distance.
Due to the frequent appearances of wanderers,
above the glass dome of the train, looming metallic skyscrapers gradually appear.
Experts are calling on hunters.
The neon lights flicker in the rain. Their kaleidoscopic colors reflected on the windows. The coral stone's metaflux is faint. It must not be easy to detect, huh? What did they find? A box with illegally sold protocores?
No. A stele. It's got all these weird patterns and symbols. They found it in the area we've been keeping an eye on.
But wasn't the base specialized in researching protocores? How did this happen?
Who knows? Sadly, part of it blown up. Nero mentioned something about it.
As the train enters the tunnel, a whistle reverberates. Tara's voice becomes muffled. Yikes. and alongside the sharp noise are ripples in the air. Something's not right. I look up, the glass dome reflecting weary faces illuminated by the screen's glow. It's evening rush hour, and the train is mostly filled with office workers and students.
What is that?
Amidst the panic, the train exits the tunnel. At that moment, accompanied by an alert from the Hunter's Watch, a shadow passes the dome.
It sounds pretty loud over there. Is something happening?
There's a wanderer outside the train. Sync up with my position now.
Got it. Switching to the emergency comms channel. Stay on your toes.
We are approaching Universum Station. Please get ready to exit the train. Passengers should use the doors on the left.
The energy fluctuation monitor inside the station has already sounded the alarm. I quickly leave the train and grab the arm of a staff member who was pushed to me by the crowd. I'm a hunter from Unicorns. Evacuate everyone until the alarm is lifted. Do not let anyone re-enter the station. The young man with silver hair stands in front of a vending machine. He moves his wrist near the green code scanner. Click. He slowly bends down. He's waiting for the energy drink to roll into the compartment, seemingly oblivious to the chaos around him. I love energy drinks.
You got a new mission. Go help out your new teammate.
My new teammate?
Hey, young lady. You can't go there.
When he lifts his head, a figure enters his line of sight. They gracefully walk on the train dome and leap over the platform, landing several meters away.
We didn't Xavier. Expect things to escalate so quickly. I've sent you the rendezvous coordinates. You'll also receive her personal info.
Oh, it's a girl. The hunter fastens the strap to the specialized hunter's zip line and gives it a strong pull. Whoosh. He disappears, a dot in the night sky.
No need to bother. We've met before.
See, I told you, Xavier is the one. He has a better personality. Xavier looks up, staring at the dark clouds in the sky that have encroached over the city.
She doesn't need protection.
Yeah, I don't. I told you, Xavier eats. Lightning illuminates the night. Thunder roars as heavy rain engulfs the neon-lit Lincoln. Stop. I told you, Xavier is the one. The other two have, like, bad personalities. Okay. Ooh, look at the height difference, too. Defeat all wanderers in the protofield within the time limits. Okay, let's see if we got this.
Let's bring it down together.
Oh, so this is a protofield. I'm like, why? Why is this guy's mansion so big?
It's time.
Here we
go. The enemies are weak. Now's our chance.
Yeah.
I'm getting the hang of this.
Yes, I am. Why am I shooting so close to him? That's so weird. It's like so unrealistic.
Pay attention to its moves. Weak.
Go back to the pit you came from. It was just a scratch. Xavier.
I'm here.
What? Where am I going?
Light, shine down upon me.
Here
okay.
I come.
Oop.
Step back.
Step back.
Can you keep up?
No, I can't. Why is he just running in random places? Is there a way to rotate the screen?
No.
Oh. I'm like, this is so freaking weird.
I won't lose you.
Stop! Not the Naruto run.
Get behind me.
Ooh. Now I'm saying get behind me. Stop, he's so protective.
It's time.
Here we go. Everything went well.
Let's go. That was easy. And it's all because we were with Xavier. It's like, nah. Because why did I have those random civilians fighting with me? A doctor and then a painter? That is so weird. Oh, another one. Dang. This subway is like infested. Okay, you got so.
Let's get this over with.
Auto mode. What am I doing with auto?
Savior.
I'm here. It's time.
Here we go.
What the heck? Oh heck no! What's going on? I don't like this.
Ethan.
Time to get serious.
Savior.
It's time.
Here we go.
Be careful not to get hit. Are you okay?
Oh, that was close.
Watch out. Can you keep up?
I didn't even sweat. You won't escape.
It's time.
Here we
go. The enemies are weak. Now's our chance.
This finisher is so nice.
I'm getting the hang of this.
Watch out, it's getting back up.
Dang. Oh! That was close.
Keep up.
I didn't even sweat.
It's time.
Here we go.
Ooh.
End it.
I forgot, what's two? Two stars, why? Because I got hit? Oh. Wait, stop, that's not bad. Mr. Beanie. He's not even wearing a beanie. I'll do that later. Training room. Okay. I guess we could do a bounty hunt. Or can we? Oh, cost something. And once again, I have to do it by myself? I was about to say. Upgrade my memories. No. Mr. Beanie. New lock-on sessions. Tap the pause button during combat to adjust your lock-on. Yeah. Well, actually, I want it. Auto.
I'm sleepy. Let's get this over with.
Okay. I'm so lazy.
This one might be a handful.
Be careful.
Are you okay?
Oop.
I was just careless.
It's time.
Here we go.
I am not afraid.
I'll show you. Light, shine down upon me.
Here I come.
Make it rain!
Can I get brushies with them?
They'll disappear once we leave the protofuel.
That's for you! You're welcome!
I'd love to know what's inside. I am not afraid. Pay attention to its movements.
Go back to the pit you came from.
The enemies are weak. Now's our chance.
Ooh.
Keep up the momentum. Watch out. It's getting back up.
Make it rain!
Let's move.
I won't lose to you.
Can you keep up?
I didn't even sweat. I'll show you.
It's time.
Here we go. My time.
End it. It's time.
Here we go.
The enemies are weak. Now's our chance. It's done.
Everything went well.
Easy. What do I even use these coins for? To go on dates or something?
I'm sleepy. Let's get this over with.
Huh? What are we doing?
Let's make this quick.
Okay, no problem.
So what's okay. Auto combat? Like, do I not press buttons or anything?
I am not as time.
So I just...
Here we go. Savior.
I'm here.
Go back to the pit you came from.
Stop.
My turn.
I'm not even playing the game.
It's time. The enemies are weak. Now's our chance.
Light, shine down upon me.
Here I come.
Go back to the pit you
came
from.
Watch out. It's getting back up. Let's move.
I won't lose to you.
It's time.
Here we go.
I am not afraid. Don't push yourself too hard.
I can still do this.
That's for you. You're welcome.
I'd love to know what's inside.
So is that why I fell? Because I didn't get it under 2 minutes? It doesn't even look like she's about to get it in under 2 minutes.
Go back to the pit you came from.
It's time.
Here we
go. The enemies are weak. Now's our chance.
Okay, maybe. Oh, yeah.
Can you keep up?
I didn't even sweat.
Watch out. It's getting back up.
Xavier.
I'm here.
Bring it off.
Stop, they failed. I didn't even play. I guess I have to play because Otto failed. You would think Otto would win. The bots lost. Sad. I'm not doing that anymore. Cause how do the bots lose? Level 3 to level 7 is insane. Whoa, que paso? Not even freezing again. We did that. We got through like maybe an hour without her freezing, so that's good. See, why do they make Zane so, look so good? And he can play a Kalimba. But he's so toxic.
We meet again.
And why is he in front of me? Like, nah. Okay. Wait, so this is a different story that we're about to follow. This is nice. Where am I? The rocking car is filled with the scent of low-quality leather. My head spins. My body is still struggling against the neurotoxin. Blurry and distant memories return to me in fragments. I was a new hunter when tragedy struck and took away people who were important to me. Ooh, this is a jump. I traveled to the Arctic, searching for the truth, and discovered an incredible power source that rested in my heart, the Aether Cord. Using the information left behind by Grandma, I concluded that what happened to me is related to Onichinus, a well-known organization in the N109 zone. They want the Aether Core in my heart. So I decided to enter the N109 zone to get closer to Onichinus and attempt to find answers. It doesn't matter if they're about the aether cord in my heart or the incident. Everything is going according to plan. I brought the most valuable bait, the aether cord, deep into the abyss that is the N109 zone. Whoever takes the bait, will this person be the one I'm looking for? This is like a huge jump.
I took a big risk to snatch prey from the nest. The reward needs to be better than that. You sure this is right? I've dripped down.
This sounds so bad. Oh my gosh. It crashed. I think this is where I'm gonna stop. But thank you for watching. I'm studying right now, but maybe I'll start streaming every Sunday. But yeah. Bye.